Praise the Lord. Good afternoon. Before we sit down, let us all go to our verse for this afternoon. Dalawang verse lang naman po, maikli. Amen. And sa the message po tayo ngayong hapon na to. Amen. And I put it in my PowerPoint because I think we don't have the, I'm not sure if you have the message in our Easy Worship, but it also is on my PowerPoint. Amen. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 1 to 2. In the Message translation, and then let's all read together with understanding. 1, 2, 3, go. Watch what God does, and then you do it. Like children who learn proper behavior from their parents. Mostly, what God does is love you. Keep company with Him, and learn a life of love. Observe how Christ loved us. His love was not cautious, but extravagant. He didn't love in order to get something from us, but to give everything of himself to us. Love like that. Amen. May the Lord add blessing to the reading of His mighty, mighty word. Tayo may makakaupo na in the very presence of the Lord. Thank you for music. Hallelujah. Good afternoon, everyone. How is everyone today? Good. Praise the Lord. Have you already greeted your seatmate ba? I'm glad that you're here today. Amen. Praise the Lord. Good afternoon again. Amen. And I'm glad that you are here today worshiping the Lord, hearing His message for this afternoon. And today, the second Sunday of February. Amen. And we are still in the month of love. Amen. Sabihin po natin, love. Amen. Love. Talagang dapat punong-puno tayo ng pag-ibig. Amen. Because it's a love month. But anyway, hallelujah, ang ating pong verse na sinabinasa. Amen. It's in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 1 to 2, and in the Message translation. Amen. And sabi po doon, I'll just gonna read it again. Watch what God does, and then you do it. Like children who learn proper behavior from their parents, mostly, what God does is love you. Amen? Yun lang po ang ginagawa ng Lord, to love us. Keep company with Him and learn a life of love. Observe how Christ loved us. His love was not cautious, but extravagant. He didn't love in order to get something from us, but to give everything of Himself to us and love like that. You know, as my part of introduction, when we talk about love, love plays an important role in Christianity. Not only in Christianity, it plays important role in the church and even in every relationship. In all relationship, love plays an important role. Amen. And if you will notice, you know, the very two, what do you call this? You know, our core values. If you will look on our core values, the first two core values that we have, amen, of our church is about love. Amen. And if you know our core values, what is our first core values? Amen. Passionate love for God. And our second core values is love and compassion for others. Amen. And makikita po natin, without love, this church cannot withstand, amen, without love for God and for others. That's why love is very, very important in a life of a believer, in a life of every Christian. And personally, unless our lives are built upon the foundation of love, they will crumble. If our life is not based on the foundation of love, our life will fall apart. Our relationship will fall apart. Imagine in a family, if there's no love, what normally happens if there's no love in the family? Amen. It crumbles, it falls, there's division. Amen. That's why love is very, very important. And it should be the foundation of every relationship for each and every one of us. That everything that we do, we should be done in love, as a 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 14. Amen. In 1 Corinthians verse chapter 16 verse 14, it says in there, everything that we do should be done in love. Amen? Do everything in love. So whatever we do it with love. Whether you eat, whether you serve, whether you worship, whether you help, whether you give, whatever we do, it should be done in love. Amen? That's why this morning, this afternoon, I have this question, amen, how would you measure your love for God and for others? Back to my PowerPoint, amen, how can we measure our love for God and for others? You know, on scale of 1 to 10, 1 which means, you know, absolutely no love for God and for others, and 10 means you love the Lord so much and you love others, amen? Well, probably, it depends on how long you've been with the Lord. Amen. Maybe some of us are just first time here, so sometimes we don't really understand about God's love. That's why you might answer 1 or 2 or low. And some of us are been here for so long and you might probably answer, you know, I'm on 8, 9, or 10. Amen. But the question is, how would you measure your love for God and for others? How would you rate yourself today? It is an honest question. How do we love God today? In the scale of 1 to 10. You know, I created these questions, but don't worry, these questions does not require you to say your answer out loud. Kayo na lang nakakaalam. Amen. But kidding aside, makikita po natin, you know, it's easy to say, I love God. It's easy to say, we love God. But does really shows, amen, but does it really shows from our deeds? When we say, I love you, Lord, does it really shows in our action? Does our action lines up with what we say? You know, there's an old saying, action speaks louder than voice, right? Action speaks louder than words. That's why you see, our love, amen, is being measured by our obedience to God's command and His doctrines. Our love for God, amen, is being measured by our obedience to God's command and to His doctrines. That's why in John chapter 14, verse 15, amen, it says in there, if you love me, obey my commandments. Amen? So when we say we love God, then obey my commandments. So when you say obey, it's an action. Amen? Obeying is an action. And half-hearted commitment or superficial commitment can look pretty good to others. Amen? Sometimes, you know, we are good in pretending that we love God. We always say, I love the Lord, amen, but only half-hearted and superficial. Some people fake it, but God knows the difference. Amen? We can come to church regularly, you know, attend every gathering, and even serve God without loving God. We can do all those things without loving God because obedience requires an action. Amen? And our action, my dear brothers and sisters, is important because again, it was mentioned again in 1 John chapter 5, verse 3 in the New Living Translation, and it says in there, loving God means keeping His commandments. And His commandments are not burdensome. Amen? As a believer of our Lord Jesus Christ, we may lift up our hands. We may support all the activities of the churches, all the mission. We may say good and appealing words. We might memorize the whole Bible verse from Genesis to Revelation. But unless we are following the commands from God's word, then we are not loving God really. Loving the Lord means obeying Him. Sabihin natin, obeying Him. Amen? Loving the Lord means obeying Him. But how do I really know if I really love Jesus? How do you know if you really love Jesus? Amen? Paano ba natin malalaman? Here, I have 3 points that I can, you know, that show evidence that we are truly love God. And I hope and I pray, amen, as we declare that I love the Lord, I love Jesus, I love Him very much. You know, last Saturday, is it last Saturday? When the CYN gathering, amen, their theme is, I love I-L-Y-S-M. I-L-Y-S-M means I love you so much, Lord. Eh, ang millennial, pahirap ng pahirap eh. Biro mo, I-L-Y, magkakabulbul ka pa eh. Eh yung Generations X, 1-4-3-4-4. Tapos. Di ba? Yung mga puti-puti na buhok dyan, alam niyo yan eh. 1-4-3-4-4, I love you very much. Amen? But kidding aside, amen, how do I really know if I love Jesus Christ? Amen? The first thing that we should know is that we are to be in constant fellowship with Him. Amen? Sabihin po natin, fellowship. One of the evidence that we really love God is we should be in constant fellowship with Him. Pag sinabi natin fellowship, amen, fellowship comes from the Greek word koinonia, amen, which means partnership, which means sharing in common or communion. So meaning, when we say we are in fellowship with Christ, when we are in fellowship with God, amen, we are partners with God. We are sharing something in common with God. Amen? And in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 9, it says in there, God will do this, for He is faithful to do what He says. And He has invited you into partnership with His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen? Fellowship with God means we are in agreement with Him in all things. So everything that we do, we are in agreement with God. We don't do things without the knowledge of God. We don't make plans without God. Amen. We don't leave God at home. When we make plans, okay, there's nothing wrong with going to school. There's nothing wrong to make business. Amen. There's nothing wrong with, you know, changing careers. But whatever you do, you're always in agreement with God. You always ask Him. Amen. You know, King David, when he goes to war, when we read the life of David, when he goes to war, he does not just go to war because he wants to go to war. Every time that he goes to war, he asks God, Lord, should I go? Will you give this to me? Will you give the Philistines to me? Will you give the Amalekites to me? Whatever David will do, amen, he is always in partner with God. That's why in everything that we do, amen, God should be, we are in fellowship with God. Amen? And fellowship is a two-way thing. Not only that we participate in the life of Christ, but allowing Christ to participate in ours too. Amen? You allow God to discipline you. You allow God to make corrections on you. You allow God to, you know, say something about your decision. It's not that, oh, Lord, this is what I want. No. You always ask the Lord, Lord, is this what you want me to do? Fellowship with Him. And a person who has constant fellowship with God share common values and attitudes. And to have fellowship with God, a man always live in truth as well and not in darkness. Some people say, I love you, Lord, but, you know, they live in darkness. They don't live in truth. And in the sight of God, we cannot pretend when we are with God. That's why, because in 1 John chapter 1, verse 6, in the New Living Translation, it says in there, so we are lying if we say we have fellowship with God, but go on living in spiritual darkness. We are not practicing the truth. Amen? That's why, you know, living in the light is important with God when we are fellowshipping with Him. Amen? Another thing that we can see, amen, that the evidence that we truly love God is we are to be in constant devotion to Him. Amen? Constant devotion. Sabihin mo natin, devotion. We are in constant devotion to Him. If you love God, you will love His words. Constant devotion. You know, once again, King David is a good example that exemplifies his devotion with God. In Psalms chapter 119, verse 97, it says in there, oh, how love your law. I meditate it all day long. Amen. That's how we have a constant devotion with God. We love God's law. We love reading His word. Amen. We don't struggle reading His word. We make time reading His word. And if we say we love God, then, you know, we need to love His word. King David meditate on His word, on God's word day and night. Amen. That's why kanina po, no, we ask, how do you measure your God's love? Kaya nga po, my dear brothers and sisters, regardless of what challenges we are against, amen, God has a solution for each and every one of us. God's always in the background. And sometimes the problem is, you know, what we meditate all day. Sabi po ni David, he meditate on God's word every day. How about us? What do we meditate every day? Pag may problema tayo, what do we meditate? Do we meditate the problems? Or do we meditate God's promises? Diba? Kaya minsan, imbis na, you know, maging okay yung buhay natin, lalo nagkakagulo. Why? Because, yeah, there's problem. There's no life without problem anyway. Kay Kristiyano ka o hindi, may problema ka. But the good thing about you being a Christian, you being with God, when you have problem, you have someone to help you. You have promises from God. Pagka hindi ka Kristiyano, how will you know the promises of God? It's the same thing with us. If we don't have devotion with the Lord, amen, how will we know His promises? That's why, what do we meditate? Do we magnify the problem or do we magnify the promises of God? Amen? That's why devotion is very important. Another thing makikita po natin, amen, another evidence that we can see here is we are in constant submission to Him. Sabihin po natin, submission. Another thing that shows our love for God is we are in constant submission to Him. What do I mean by that? Submission. Simply would love what God loves and hate what God hates. When we are in submission to God, amen, we love what God loves and hate what God hates. And the thing is, do we know what God's love and what God hates? That sometimes the problem with us, that's why we can't submit to God, we don't know what He loves and what He hates. And the Bible says in Romans chapter 12, verse 9 to 21, mahaba po ito, but this is where we can find what God's love and what God hates. Amen. And if we are in constant submission with Him, amen, malalaman po natin kung anong gusto ng Lord at ayaw niya. Amen. And sabi po doon, in verse 9, love must be sincere. Hate what is evil. Cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in love. Honor one another above yourself. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor serving the Lord. Ito po yung mga gusto ng Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. Share with the Lord's people who are in need. Practice hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Mourn with those who mourn. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be proud, but be willing to associate with people of low position. Do not be conceited. In verse 17, do not repay evil for evil. Be careful to do what is right in the eyes of everyone. If it's possible, as far as it depends on you, live at peace with everyone. Do not take revenge, my dear friends, but leave room for God's wrath, for it is written, it is mine to avenge. I will repay, says the Lord. On the contrary, if your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he is thirsty, give him something to drink. In doing this, you will heap burning coals on his head. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. Amen? So, if we are in submission with God, we know what He likes, we know what He loves, and what He's not. That's why He asks, if we really truly love God, amen, alam natin yung ayaw ng Diyos. Right. Mayroong isa nang sinabi doon, do not repay evil with evil. So, if someone, you know, do something bad to you, anong gagawin mo? Sabi ng Lord, do not return evil with evil. Do not repay evil with evil. But sabi doon, bless and do not curse. Bless those who persecute you. Right? Pero kasi, if you don't know God, if you don't love the Lord, yung self, yung flesh pa rin natin ang alam natin, eye for an eye. Tooth for a tooth. Pag tinanggalan niya ako ng isang ngipin, dalawa tatanggalin ko sa kanya. Ganun tayo eh. Right? But that's not in fellowship with God. But that is not in submission with God. Amen. We don't live according to this world anymore, but we are living according to the standard of God. And if we truly love God, then we are in submission to Him. Amen? That's why as a believer of Christ, God expects us to grow. Sabihin po natin, grow. We need to grow in love. Not only love for God, but also love for others. And in Philippians chapter 1, verse 9, this is the prayer of Paul, amen, that he prays that our love, that God's love, amen, will overflow more and more. This is the prayer of Paul that each and every one of us, the love of God will continue to overflow more and more in our lives. And that you will keep on growing in knowledge and understanding. Amen? This is what God wants to be us experiencing in this world. That our love will overflow more and more. It's not just when we got saved, amen, God did not limit our salvation to merely escape from judgment. Amen. We don't get saved just to save. Amen. The burning hell. We are not just saved. Amen. To go to heaven, but we are saved as well so that the love of God will be expressed to many people. And God's love is a sign of being born again to each and every one of us. You know, a person who display love for God and to others is an indication that they really love God. Sabi nga po sa 1 John chapter 4, verse 8, ano po sabi doon? 1 John chapter 4, verse 8, whoever does not love God does not know God. Because God is love. Amen? That's why love is very, very important. We need the love of God grow in us. Amen? We need to increase our capacity to love. Because our nature is always selfish. We all want to take care of ourselves first before others. That's our nature. It's all me. Me. But here, God is saying that we need to increase our capacity to love God and others. Amen? But how can we do this? Maikli lang po tayo ngayong hapon na to. Amen? How can we increase our capacity to love? That's why in my next PowerPoint, makikita po natin, back in our verse in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 1 to 2, makikita po natin, there are three things that we can see in there. Amen? How to increase our capacity to love. Amen? Kanina po, tinanong natin, ano ang measurement ng iyong pagmamahal sa Lord? How do you measure your love to God? If it's still low, then we need to increase our capacity to love. Amen. It's not the end of the world. That's why you are here. That's why we are here. We are here to learn. Amen. We are here to learn God's word. And in these verses, Ephesians chapter 5, verse 2, we can see three things that we can increase our capacity to love. Amen. Number one po, makita po natin, the first thing that we can do to increase our capacity to love is to learn. Sabi po natin, learn. Doon po sa ating binasa, sabi po doon, watch what God does and then you do it. Like children who learn proper behavior from their parents. Whether we like it or not, our children, amen, imitate us, right? Yung mga pag-post-post, yung sa mga picture, amen, the way we talk, they imitate us. It's the same thing with God. If we want to learn about the love of God, if we want to increase our capacity to love, then we need to learn about God's love. We need to learn about God. Amen? And if we want, you know, in this world, if you want to please someone, like for example, if you want to please your spouse, if you want to please your partner, if you want to please your children, your parents, what you need to do? You need to learn what they love. You need to learn what they like. Right? Ano bang gusto ng aking nanay? Ano bang gusto ng aking asawa? Amen. You don't just go, like for example, you're buying gifts to someone, to your loved one. You don't just go and buy something, oh, okay na to. No, right? You learn, oh, this is what my wife likes. This is what my husband likes. He will like this very much when I buy this. This is my children will like. This is my parents will like. This is my friends will like. Eto, crush ko to. This is what she's going to be like. Amen. We need to learn. We need to learn. Same with Jesus Christ. We need to learn how God does it. How God loves the world. And if we want to increase our capacity to love to God and others, we must know about Jesus in order to love Him more. Amen? That's why, you know, all that we can do, do all we can, amen, to know Christ in our lives. We need to know Christ. Sabi nga po ni Peter, in order to learn Jesus, in order to learn about Jesus, Peter command believers to grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ, which is in 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 18. Amen? If you want to know Christ, if you want to learn about Jesus, grow in the grace and in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior. My dear brothers and sisters, we cannot expect to walk in love but not growing in knowledge and in wisdom who Jesus is in our lives. Knowing how He loved, amen, knowing how He loved is very important to each and every one of us. Amen? Learn. Learn about God. Learn about Him. Learn about Jesus Christ. Learn about His Word. Amen? For example, in John chapter 3, verse 16, what can we learn about the Lord in there? John 3, 16, sabi po doon, for God so loved the world. Amen? What can we learn about it? For God so loved the world. We learn that God so loved the world. So meaning, amen, if we know that God so loved the world, then if we are imitating the Lord Jesus Christ, sabi natin po kanina, amen, to love God is to have submission in Him, to have bond in Him, to have fellowship with Him. Amen. So if we love God, then we should love the world as well. Meaning, when God so loved the world, meaning He loves everyone. So us, as a believer of Christ, we should love everyone. Hindi po tayo namimili. Ito, mukhang goons. Wag muna yan. Okay to, hindi pa naliligo to. Amoy kahapon. Or this one is not unlovable. Amen? Dito muna tayo sa mga lovable. But God says, He loves the world. Meaning, each and every one of us means we need to love everyone as well. Amen? We are not, anong tawag doon? Hindi po tayo namimili. We are not choosy. Amen. Meron nga pong kanta in the 70s. Ito, alam na rin ito ng mga may maputing buhok eh. Ano ba yung kanta na yun? What the world needs now is love, sweet love. Diba? Alam na alam mo. Oh. It's the only thing that there is just too little of. Sabi pa niya sa pangatlo, what the world's need now is love, sweet love, not just for some, but for everyone. Diba? Dapat ang love, not just for some, for everyone. Amen? And that's how God loved everyone. So when we give love, it's not just for some, but for everyone as well. Amen? You know, my dear brothers and sisters, there's a lot of people out there are hurting. There's a lot of people in there, young people who are, you know, in despair, in distress, hopeless. And if we are learning from God, then, you know, we can reach them out. We are not here just, you know, we don't invite people just, you know, para mapuno tayo. No. Well, that's probably one purpose, but the main purpose why we are inviting people so that they can experience transformation in their lives. Right? That's the most important thing, that we can share the love of Christ to many people. So that whatever we can experience, you know, from the love of God, they can share it, they can experience it as well. Amen? That's why if we want to increase our capacity, then we need to learn from God. Learn about Jesus Christ. Learn about His sacrifice. Learn about the resurrection of Christ. Learn, amen, the love of Christ to humanity. Amen? Kaya nga po, second, makikita po natin, second thing that we can, you know, increase our capacity to love is we can say the word bond. Sabi po natin, bond. Amen? In the next verse that we can see, makikita po natin, sabi doon, keep company with Him and learn a life of love. Sabi nila, the first 10 minutes of your day, amen, set your entire mood for the whole day. So when you wake up, the first 10 minutes of your day will set your entire mood during the day. So how can you start your day? I believe the best thing to start your day is to keep company with God. Amen? You start with day by connecting with God. That's why it's very important. Amen? Yun nga, no, sa EGR, pinag-aaralan natin, first thing in the morning, right? You have your devotion. Hindi yung tinatakot ka na, no devotion, no food, no. Ano lang yun? Kunyari lang yun. But the main thing is, amen, we set our day. Amen, the first 10 minutes of our day sets the whole thing. That's why if we, amen, give our time for God first thing, amen, for sure, our day will have a good day. Amen? We need to develop a habit of starting our day with the Lord and then consciously walking with Him throughout the day. Amen? You know, Billy Graham says he's spending 30 to 60 minutes at the start of his day. Sabi niya. And after spending time in reading and meditation of the Word, when he finished, he doesn't say, "Goodbye, Lord. I'll see you tomorrow." Instead, he say, "Lord, let's go." Amen? Kaya nga po, yung kanyang araw, yung buong kanyang araw, eh napakaganda because the Lord is with him. Amen? And as we start our day, Lord, let's go. Be with me today. Whatever, you know, things that will I came across today, I will see my boss again, the boss that I really like. You always ask me to do something. You know, Lord, let's go. O na bahala. Right? We keep company with our Lord Jesus Christ. We are in bond with Him that wherever we go, amen, He is with us. That's why, my dear brothers and sisters, spending time in God's presence is essential to our Christian journey. We are not going. Sabi nga po ni Moses, di ba? We are not gonna go if your presence is not with us. It should be the same with us. Amen? We will not go if God's presence is with us. Because everything that we must desire within us, that we must desire, amen, is to be with God. Sabi nga po sa Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 13, sabi po doon, "If you look for me wholeheartedly, you will find me." Ang Diyos po, hindi po malayo. He's always there. He's always with us. If we allow Him to be with us. And for sure, God is always accessible for us. Sabi nga po sa John chapter 4, verse 24, "God's Spirit and they that worship Him must worship in spirit and in truth." Kaya nga po, therefore, no matter where you are, kahit nasaan po tayo, amen, God is also there. We can call on God at all times. Amen? We can worship Him in our cars while we are driving. we can worship Him while we are cleaning, you know, we are doing the hockey. Wherever we are, God is accessible to each and every one of us. Amen? How can we bond with God? How can we connect with God? Well, of course, we need to commit a quality time with Him. For our relationship to grow, for husband and wife, a quality time is needed. Amen? For the love to grow. If you don't have time to each other, I don't think your love will grow, right? Kaya dapat, palagi tayong magkatabi natutulog, mag-asawa. Sino po rito hindi magkatabi nagtutulog? Hindi po tama yun. Kailangan magkatabi kayo, husband and wife. Hindi yung katabi nyo, yung anak nyo. Or pwede yung katabi yung anak nyo, nasa kabilang side, pero kayo magkatabi pa din. Because you need to bond. Amen? To bond is to share your thoughts and feelings with your partners. Amen? It's the same thing with our Lord Jesus Christ. You need to share your feelings. Ano ba nararamdaman mo? Eh, ang problema, if you have these feelings, eh, punta ka agad sa Facebook mo, tapos sasabihin mo sa status mo, ano ba yung status mo? Complicated. Share mo kay Lord kaya, para hindi complicated. Amen? You know, you share feelings with your partner. You share your feelings with God. Amen? Huwag po tayong mahihiya sa Lord. Another thing that we can bond is, you know, ask other questions. You ask questions. What do you like? Diba? Kaya kayo nagkakabond eh. Kaya kita niyo yung mag-girlfriend and mag-boyfriend. Paano sila nagiging stronger? Because they talk so much, right? Sino rito yung mga nagliligawan ng unang panahon? Yung mga mapuputing buhok, magagaling yung mga yan eh. Nung unang panahon, di ba? You talk too much. You don't, you know, you have so many times to talk to each other. Naubusan na kayo na pinag-usapan, pero andayan nyo pa rin tinatanong. That's why you get bond. Nagiging kayong sweet. Eh, pag hindi na kayo nag-uusap, ano nangyari sa inyo? Nagiging bitter na, di ba? That's why, pag nagiging bitter yung inyong relationship, bring back the memories, yung pag-uusap nyo. Diba? Ang problema eh, nakarating kayo sa Canada, yung isa nagtatrabaho sa umaga, yung isa nagtatrabaho sa gabi, eh yung question nyo, oh, nakapagluto ka ba? Alis na ako. Yun yung question eh. Napakain mo na ba yung anak mo? Paligawan mo na ba? Sumeldo ka na ba? Diba? Yun yung mga question eh. Pero, yung question na, how's your day today? How's your work treated you today? Amen? How's your children? Did your children give a hard time on you? Mukhang pagod na pagod ka, honey. Upo ka muna, ako na bahala. Mga ganun ba? Hindi yung, ano, niluto mo, hindi masarap. Ba't yung adobo mo parang barbecue? Ang daming asukal. Ang ganyan si Pastora nun eh. Konting asukal lang. Saka konting suka. Eh, naparami asukal. Di sinabi na yung suka. Naparami na naman yung suka. Dinagdagan na naman na asukal. Eh, matamis na naman. Nilagyan na naman na suka hanggang sa matigas na. Yung parang bananak yun na. Yung baboy. Okay lang. Pero ngayon, sabi niya kayo ng umaga, expert na siya sa adobo. O, biray mo, 20 years. 20 years kang magtsatsaga. Okay lang yun. At least, you know, you bond. Amen? You bond with your partners. It's the same thing with God. Amen? Don't worry because God is full of patience. God is loving. Kaya hanggat hindi pa dumarating ang Lord, we still have hope with God. Amen? Kaya nga po, bond. And last, my point is practice. Sabihin po natin, practice. Sabi po sa last sentence in our verse in Ephesians chapter 5 verse 1 to 2, sabi po doon, amen, love like that. Love like that. Meaning, we need to practice. Amen? Practice love. Sabi nga nila, practice makes it perfect. Pero may mas maganda raw doon kasi we are not perfect. Kahit anong klaseng practice natin, hindi natin mape-perfect because we are only human. Amen? Kahit nga sa mga tumutugtog kanina nag-practice sila. 1 hour sila nag-practice. Pero ang gulo pa din. Diba? Kaya practice does not make it perfect. Pero sabi nila, practice makes progress. Yon, may progress naman, di ba? Palakpakan po natin ang Diyos na buhay. Kaya yun po yung dapat nating, you know, motto, practice makes progress. Ibig sabihin, amen, that, you know, when we practice, we can have progress. Right? If you are practicing love, then yung pagiging magagalitin mo, yung pagiging masungit mo, amen, gradually na iba. Because you are in progress. Every time we practice, every time we recommit ourselves, things get better and easier. And the more you practice giving love to God and to anyone, it gets easier to do it without struggle. Amen? Kaya, sino ang pagpapraktisan mo ngayon? Sino yung nakasibangot kanina? Sino yung nag-snub sa'yo kanina? Practice. Sino yung hindi kumamay sa'yo kanina? Sino yung nagbigay ka ng smile pero in-snub ka? Practice. Pagpraktisan mo. O ano? Mahirap? Kaya nga, practice. Practice makes progress. Kaya nga po sa Philippians chapter 4 verse 9 in the New Living Translation, keep putting into practice all you learned and received from me. Amen. God is saying to each and every one of us, all the things that you have learned from me, all the things that you have learned from God and received from God, you need to keep putting it into practice. When God says, love your enemies, love your neighbor as you love yourself, love God with all your heart, practice it. How do you practice it? Amen. And sabi po doon, everything you heard from me and saw me doing, then God of peace will be with you. Amen. When we are practicing it, God will be with us. Pag nireject ka ng taong gusto mong pagpraktisan, sasabihin sa'yo ng Lord, don't worry. You are not the one who's being rejected. It is me. That's why you don't feel bad about it. When we are sharing the word of God, sometimes, amen, di ba? Sino po nakaka-experience nun? Pag mag-share ka, they reject the word. And sometimes we feel that we are the ones being rejected. No. And if God is with you, sabihin ng Lord, you're not the one being rejected. It is me who is being rejected. That's why don't worry about it. Let's find another person. Amen. For you to share the word of God. Amen. But the most important thing is we need to practice. Practice what we learn from God. Amen? Kaya nga sabi nila, love is like a muscle. Woo. Where that came from? Pero, parang totoo naman nga, love is like a muscle. Why? The more you use it, the more it develops. Parang muscle. Amen? The more you use your muscle, lalong lumalaki. It's the same thing with love. The more you use your love grows. Amen? Pwede? Pwede. Like lang naman eh. Hindi naman sinabing love is a muscle. Like a muscle. That's why if we keep on using it, then for sure, it will develop and we will have a loving, a true loving person. Amen? We will become a true loving person. The more we practice, the more it becomes second nature and we will become genuinely loving person. Amen? Praise the Lord. Palakpakan muna natin Diyos ng buhay. Kaya nga po as I end, amen, madali lang naman yung tatlong yun. Madali lang naman tandaan. Learn, bond, and practice. We learn about Jesus, we bond with Him, and we practice what He says. Amen? Simple lang naman. That's why, as I end, our capacity to love comes from God. Amen? It is all comes from God. He set the example which we have to follow. And obviously, all of us needs to grow in this area of love. I hope and I pray na hindi lang po February, amen, na mag-exercise po tayo ng love because it's a love month. But every day of our lives, until Jesus comes, that we practice love. And we have the desire to increase our capacity to love. You know, Jesus taught the love for God and others is the greatest commandment. This is the greatest commandment that the Lord Jesus Christ give to each and every one of us. Ano sabi niya sa Matthew chapter 22 verse 37? In the New Living Translation, it says in there, Jesus replied, "You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind." Amen? This is the greatest commandment of God. And the Bible says, if you love me, you will obey my commands. So technically, we don't have a choice but to love. Whether it's hard, whether we don't like it, because we think that, oh, I cannot forgive that person. It gives me so much hurt. I cannot love him. But the thing is not about us. It is about God. And if God's saying, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind, as this love flows in us, we can love other person, our neighbor, and all the people around us. Also, love is the identifying mark of a Christian. If we say we are a Christian, well, love should be evident in us. That's why in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 3b, it says in there, ang sabi doon, without love, I am nothing. Without love, I am nothing. Sabi nila, spirituality is not measured by giftedness, but it is measured by love that comes from God. Paul did not say, without love, I have nothing. But God said, without love, I am nothing. Meaning, every believer, every Christian, every church cannot be a healthy person without love, no matter how gifted we are. We can have all the talents, we can have all the gifts, but without love, it is nothing. We can have all the sacrifices. You can even give your, you know, all your possessions, but without love, it still gain us nothing. That's why love is very, very important in the life of a believer. Kaya nga po, babalik po tayo dun sa kanina question natin, how would you measure your love for God and for others? gaano ba kalaki yung pagmamahal natin ngayon. But regardless of your answer, sa mga oras nito, Jesus wants to indwell in you. Jesus wants His love to indwell in each and every one of us. If we need more love, then Jesus can fill us up. If we have so much love, then God can still fill us more love. As long as we are desiring for His love this afternoon. Amen. That's why tayo pong lahat ay tumayo sa mga oras na ito. You know, one of the very reason why sometimes people cannot give love, merong mga ano yan, enemy. There's an enemy of love. Ano po yung mga enemy ng love? There's jealousy, there's possessiveness, there's pride, even mistrust. That's why you cannot give love, that's why you cannot love even God, because there's pride in our hearts. But if you want to increase your capacity to love today, sabi po sa Romans chapter 5 verse 5, sabi po doon, and hope does not put us to shame because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has given to us. There's no way we can, you know, fabricated love. There's no way we can get love anywhere else. It's through the Holy Spirit who poured out His Spirit to each and every one of us. The key to have love into our hearts is to have the Lord Jesus Christ into our hearts first. The only way we can receive the Holy Spirit is receiving the Lord Jesus Christ as our Lord and personal Savior. That's why today, if you desire to have love in our hearts, then we must receive the Lord Jesus Christ into our hearts. That's why today, I invite you to, you know, just bow down your heads and close your eyes. I know those questions, well, it's hard to answer really. How do I really love God? How much do I really love God? But if your desire this afternoon is to love Him more in your life, then we must acknowledge the Lord Jesus Christ into our hearts and even renounce any hindrances that make that love pour into our hearts today. And if you want to receive that love that comes from God, I want you to raise your hand so that God can see that you desire His love, that He can be poured out His love to each and every one of us today. And as we raising up our hand, follow me with this simple prayer. Lord Jesus,
I acknowledge
that I am a sinner.
That I am a sinner.
I have many shortcomings, Lord.
I have many shortcomings, Lord.
That's why today. I ask for your forgiveness.
I ask for your forgiveness.
Cleanse me from all of my unrighteousness.
Cleanse me from all of my unrighteousness.
Purify my heart, Lord.
Purify my heart.
Create in me a clean hand.
Create in me a clean hand.
A pure heart.
A pure heart.
Renew a right spirit within me. And Lord Jesus today, I invite you
to be my Lord,
to be my master. Come into my heart.
Dwell in my heart today.
And let your love, Lord,
flows in me.
through the Holy Spirit.
Through the Holy Spirit.
Lord,
Lord,
help me to live a life.
Help me to live a life
that is pleasing unto you.
That is pleasing unto you.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Let us all one sing to the Lord. Hallelujah.
This is my desire to
allow your power, your presence upon each and every one today. If we need more love in our hearts, I pray, God, that your power will continue to overflow more and more in our lives today. Lord, if there's anything, any bitterness, any hatred, any pride, any selfish desire that's still in our hearts today, remove it, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. anything that hinder us to love, to give love, Lord, to you and to your children, O God. Cleanse us, O God, in the name of Jesus. May you fill our hearts with compassion. May you fill our hearts, Lord, with mercy. Fill us our hearts, O God, with grace, O God, in the name of Jesus. And allow us, O God, to experience more of your love, more of your presence, more of your goodness in our life today. I pray, Lord, in the name of Jesus, increase our capacity to love. To love you, Lord, with all of our hearts, our soul, our mind, our strength, and to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. Lord, help us. Teach us, Lord, how to forgive. As you forgive our trespasses, Lord, help us to forgive one another. Give us a heart, Lord, that a strong heart to release forgiveness to those who have hurt us. I know a lot of reason why we cannot love because of our hurt. That's why today, give it to the Lord. Give it to God. Allow God to move in your hearts today. Hallelujah. Lord, help us, Lord, to exercise our faith today. Learn us, Lord, help us to practice, Lord, what we have learned today. If we need to give forgiveness to our spouse because we don't think that they deserve love, allow God to touch you today. Let the forgiveness of our Lord Jesus Christ overpower our whole being today, so that we can give forgiveness to those that we love, to those that what God, whom He loved. My dear brothers and sisters, the Bible always clearly says, for God so loved the world. Whoever the person that God has brought you, God loved them. God loves them so much. That's why, as the Bible declares, if you love me, you will obey my command. And God's command to you and to me is to love them. That's why, if there's any misunderstanding in the family, if there's anything misunderstanding between brothers and sisters, if there's any misunderstanding in any relationship, this is the time to practice the love that God has given to each and every one of us. That's why if you are with your family today, I want you to, you know, come together. And if there's something that we need to release forgiveness, or just probably say, I love you. I love you, my love, my honey, my wife, my husband. I love you, my child. I love you, mom. I love you, dad. Well, it's time to give love. And even our brotherly love, our sisterly love. Amen. Kung meron po tayong mga, you know, hindi natin kasama ating mga pamilya, you know, men to men, women to women, we can share the love that God has poured out to each and every one of us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Died for me.
Lord, you died for me. Forever my praise will go to
Oh God. Thank you for choosing me.
Thank you for choosing me to be your child and bear your name.
Say to the Lord, thank you for loving me, Lord.
Thank you for loving me.
Thank you for loving me.
Thank you.
Say it to your parents, thank you for loving me, Mom, Dad. Say it to your children, thank you for loving me. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. And as we move on to our second part of our service, our communion service, may I invite all the elements to come into the front as a sign of our love to God. It is an ordinance that the Bible, the Lord Jesus Christ, has given to each and every one of us that we will always remember what He has done on the cross for us. One of the sign of love that we can show into our loved ones is, you know, remember all the good things that He has done, that they are done for us, right? Being gratitude, being thankful to what they're done to us. It's the same thing with our Lord Jesus Christ. One way of showing our love to Him is by remembering what He has done on the cross for us. And today, you know, we may ask why we celebrate communion. There are many reasons why we need to exercise and celebrate communion. And one reason that we can see in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23 to 25, the first reason why we do communion is to remember. In verse 23, it says, "And therefore I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night He was betrayed, took bread. When He had given thanks, He broke it and said, 'This is my body which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.'" And in verse 25, again, the Lord mentioned it, that whenever you drink it, do this in remembrance of me. The very first reason why we are celebrating communion is because we need to remember the Lord Jesus Christ, what He has done on the cross for us. The second reason why we do communion is because we need to rejoice. In verse 26, the Bible says, "But whenever you eat the bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until He comes." You know, if we are proclaiming something, ibig sabihin, we are rejoicing. We are not proclaiming that, you know, we are not rejoicing. That's why when we proclaim, we are in rejoicing. We declare that God has risen from the dead. Our God that we serve, our God that we worship is alive into our hearts. That's why we are rejoicing. Amen. The third reason that we can see is the reason why we commemorate and celebrate communion is to repent. In verse 27 to 28 of 1 Corinthians chapter 11, sabi po doon, "So then, whoever eats the bread or drinks the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of sinning against the body and the blood of the Lord. Everyone ought to examine themselves before they eat of the bread and drink from the cup." And today, we have the opportunity to repent and experience His forgiveness and cleansing power to each and every one of us. Kanina po, we pray the prayer of acceptance, and I hope and I pray, you know, that we have renounced, we have asked for forgiveness for all the sins that we have in our hearts. Because if there's still anything that is hidden into our hearts, sabi po nung Bible, amen, we are guilty of sinning against the body and the blood of the Lord. Amen. We are guilty. And last reason why we need to take the communion is to reconcile. Sabi po natin, reconcile. In verse 29, it says in there, "For those who eat and drink without discerning the body of Christ, eat and drink judgment on themselves." We need to understand, amen, that sin separates us from God. Whenever we sin, amen, we are being separated with God because God cannot tolerate sin. But when we are partaking the Holy Communion and when we ask for forgiveness from the Lord, then we are reconciled back to Him. Amen? That's why today I believe, amen, the reason why we celebrate communion is because we are now reconciled with God. We have now relationship again with Him. That's why there are so many things that we need to rejoice when we are partaking the Holy Communion. Amen? That's why today, let us all stretch forth our hands to all these elements. Amen, that whatever the promises of the Lord Jesus Christ, whatever that He has done on the cross, amen, all the benefits of the cross, all the promises that He has given to those who believe in Him shall come to pass to those children who believes. And as we partake all this element, I pray, O God, hallelujah, that Your power will continue to be upon this element, O Lord, the bread that symbolizes Your body and the fruit of the vine that symbolizes Your blood, O God. Hallelujah. And as we partake all this element, O Lord, hallelujah, let there be healing. Let there be deliverance. Let there be salvation, O God, in the name of Jesus, to our physical body, to our relationship, O God, to our family, to our loved ones, O God, in the name of Jesus. Let it be done, O God, according to Your will and purpose, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank You. We honor You in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Let's all distribute.
What love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called His sons and daughters, precious in His sight. Greater love this world has never seen, when He hung on that tree, oh, why would such a thing for dirty sinners like you and me, oh God. Thank you for loving me when on the cross you made it serene. Lord, you died for me forever. My grace will go to thee, oh God. Thank you for choosing me to be your child.
Hallelujah. If we are all ready, let us all lift up the bread. In 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 22 to 24, it says in there, "For I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.'" Let us all partake of the bread and thank the Lord. Let us all lift up the juice of the fruit of the vine that symbolizes the body, the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. In verse 25 to 26, in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, says in there, "In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me.' Whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." Let us all partake of the juice. And can we utter a prayer of thanksgiving to the Lord? Come on, church. Thank God for all what he's done. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, that at the cross, Lord, you conquered death, so that we will not experience eternal death. Thank you, Lord, that you have conquered every sicknesses and diseases. And by your stripes, Lord, we are healed. Lord, thank you for all the healing, O God, to our physical body. Hallelujah. Lord, heal us, O God. If there's anything in your body, in your physical body that needs healing, I want you to touch it. Hallelujah. And claim it, Lord. I claim it that you have received the healing in the name of Jesus. Let the blood of Jesus, the body of the Lord Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus, heal your physical body in the name of Jesus. If there's any relationship healing, financial healing, hallelujah, hallelujah, heal them, O God, in the name of Jesus. And even, Lord, any broken relationship, Lord, bind any broken relationship, binding up their wounds, O God, in the name of Jesus. Heal every heart, O God, from any bitterness. Heal every heart, O God, from any hurts, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. And let the love of Christ flows to each and every one of us. Maraming salamat po, God. Seal all the words that we have heard today. Hallelujah. Seal it, O Lord. Let the love of Christ flows in us wherever we go, wherever you set our foot upon, O God. And may our lives, O God, be a blessing to many people as well, that the love of God will be shared to many people, to our friends, to our family, to our loved ones, to our classmate, in the name of Jesus. Maraming salamat po. I declare prosperity, provisions, blessings to your people today. Hallelujah, to seek you, to come to you, O God, today, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, maraming salamat po, O Lord. Hallelujah, and we will declare that the victory is ours already, and the love of God is upon us, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you, we honor you, we bless you. In Jesus' name, this is all we pray. Everybody will say, amen and amen. God bless you all.